Welcome, students. In this very brief screencast, I'm going to talk about how you can be a great listener in your class, listening to your peers give their speeches. So imagine yourself an audience member in a public speech, and this is really my thoughts on how you can create a great space through listening for the public speaker and really take in the speech objectively. So my first tip on listening to speeches is put all distractions away. That means that any issues, problems, mood you're in, and this goes for all classes. Take all those distractions, things on your mind, leave them at the door. So when you walk into every class, whether the professor is presenting or your peers, you are ready and to single task and focus on the speaker. And so put any distractions away you might have. Also, leave any biases that you have off. Imagine listening to a speaker you already know you disagree with. What I'm asking you to do is turn your bias off. Don't form an opinion. Try to listen to each speaker objectively. And we see this now in political debates. When someone politically we don't agree with is speaking, we tend to editorialize, opinion, disagree right throughout. What I'm saying is don't do those things. Listen objectively. Take every new experience, every new speech as an opportunity to listen bias-free. So put away those distractions and shut those biases off and really try to listen as objectively as you can. Have you ever been in a speech, been performing a speech and looked out and seen this? People on their phones, people not paying attention. In fact, it's one of the greatest fears that public speakers have is when the audience is not paying attention. So what I say in this situation is, as an audience member, be a hotspot in the audience. A hotspot is someone who's really engaged, making lots of eye contact, showing nonverbal gestures that you're listening, head nod, eye contact, leaning in, smiling, and really showing nonverbally that you're listening at all times. Keep your eyes on the speaker. The burden of eye contact is on the listener in Western culture because we really value eye contact. So when I say be a hotspot in the audience, be someone that the speaker can look to and know you're paying attention and can talk to and kind of focus on you as a hotspot. But show eye contact. Watch out for cell phones, distracted, head down on the desk. Show lots of nonverbal gestures, leaning in, eye contact, nodding, and really demonstrate that you're enthusiastically listening through nonverbal gestures. And you can be like this guy here, thumbs up and a big smile. My next slide has to do about filling out the peer evaluation. We all know we need to fill out an evaluation form on the speaker. Please do not fill it out during the speaker's speech. So while the speaker is delivering their speech, please don't do this. Fill out the form. Wait. You will have time at the end to write down some thoughts and fill out the form. So please wait and don't fill it out during. Wait till after and take the minute to fill it out. Also, when you fill out the form, be ready to see qualities that you enjoyed about the presentation and talk about things that you felt the speaker was challenged with. And so this is really important where you're observing. So things that you could like could be the PowerPoint, the visuals, the clear speech, the clear main ideas, the introduction, the conclusion. And conversely, those are things that the speaker could be challenged with. You might also note hand gestures that maybe they're playing with their hands and maybe they have nervousness going on. I'm being dramatic, but You might notice hand gestures, body gestures. Remember, when you're listening and observing speeches, you're taking in a package of messages. The verbal, what they say, and the nonverbal, what's their body telling you during the presentation. And so you'll make those notes on the peer evaluation form. What did you like? What did you feel they could work on? And so really filling out that form is imperative after the speech. In conclusion, again, put away all distractions and biases. Be bias-free, be neutral, be unopinionated, and really take in each presentation as a new experience. Observe the entire package of messages. I already said this. The entire package is the verbal message, what they're saying, and the nonverbal, what their body is saying, what's their PowerPoint, what are their visuals. Be a hotspot in the audience. Be someone they want to look out to and see a smile and a nod and a leaning in, and be that hotspot that they can really look to. I like making eye contact with the presenter. And so presenters, if you're really engaged as a listener, presenters will find you. And again, don't fill out that paperwork during. Wait till after the speech, please. And don't give the speaker the time to an attention that they deserve. Don't fill out a form during the speech. Lastly, find positives. What do you like? Find a couple qualities that you really liked, and find a couple qualities that you feel like they could work on with their public speaking. There's always positive things to note in every experience, and there's always challenges to note in every experience. You putting them on the form can really help that speaker out and help you learn how to give feedback. That's my conclusion and overall on how and things you can do as an audience member listening to speeches. If you haven't, follow me on Twitter at Prof. Maddie, and I hope this screencast was helpful. Be well.